Here is some of it being demonstrated in what you rather clumsily call trance. And through these lips this energy is pouring. Is it spent? No. We pour it into your souls. Now, at this point, we test your faith. Proof, as we've said, which the scientists vary in accepting. We smile, as we've said, at the standards you place, called evidence. You say this must be based upon the evidence that would be accepted in a court of law. Well, we remember years ago talking about looking through our instrument's eyes. Our instrument used to go in his boyhood and young manhood to music halls to see comic sketches. And we recall one of your comedians staging a court of law. And the type of evidence which some of you people demand isn't much better than those comedians shown in their sketch. There's no such thing as proof along the lines of your earthly standards of evidence. To go back to the scientists again, just whilst we're digressing slightly here, there was a period when Moontrail was called upon within this very building to assist psychic researchers who questioned us. And there was one who thought that he had got the last, very last piece of analysis that would prove something connected with Moontrail's previous incarnation. He asked a question in the psychic researcher that was calculated either to trip up the medium for fraudulence, which was so palpably obvious in his mind, or to leave Moontrail in a situation that would make us break cosmic law. He couldn't know that. What he thought was proof was an answer to the question, who was the principal pupil of the master Plotinus? And we refused to answer. Otherwise, it would be an uncosmic thing for us to do. They couldn't see why. And we did not feel it incumbent upon us to go to the pains of proving why. But suffice it to say that these are judged to be standards of proof. And they are no such thing. Now, at the stage where we tell you that this breath of spirit is pouring abundantly into you now so that you can feel the life of spirit, at that point you must use faith. Why? Because by all the standards of so-called proof, namely testing by the five senses of your physical body, the answer is negative. Can you feel this power? With your hands, we mean, the sense of touch? No. Can you see it? No. Can you smell it? No. Can you taste it? No. Can you hear it? No. Very well, says your proof-seeking, objective, physical brain. It doesn't exist, he's a liar. Five little physical senses and you demand proof. You even want to hear with your ears messages from Uncle Joe, whilst your soul knows it's beating in tune with suns and worlds and moons and stardust and nebulae. Are you in tune with cosmos? If you are, then you don't need proof on a physical plane. We know the answer is from those unevolved. We do. And adequate provision is made for the unevolved. But for those of you who are evolving, who are pilgrims on the quest for everlasting truth, at the point where we say to you, we are pouring spiritual life into your souls now, faith, unshakable faith, will convince you because it is a convictional belief. You can't think of Moontrail as a liar if you're in tune with us. And you know with a convictional belief that when we say we've poured spirit power into your soul, you have faith to accept it. If we can say in our closing words, before we strive to answer any questions you may want to ask, If we can say these words, we are sure that you will catch the gist of tonight's talk to you. These are the words we want to say. Faith, being a convictional belief, is your one great asset where negatives assail you so often. We've told you that the negative life you live on earth is your training ground to bring you strength of positivity. And only by the faith of a convictional belief that this is logical and possible can you possibly do this. And unless, and oh, how we'd like to say this to you people who are coming through an incarnation that may not complete your growth, who may have to come back to earth again, may we say this to you. Unless you learn the laws of transmutation, no amount of religious living in churches or cathedrals can help you. Nothing to do with religious script, whether it be the Bible, the Quran, the Talmud, the Upanishads, the Zend, the Vestas, Vedas, or the Bhagavad Gita, makes no difference. Whether you're a Baptist, a Wesleyan, an Anglican, or a Roman Catholic, or a Mohammedan, or a Jain, makes no difference. You must learn the law of transmutation. And for that statement, you require the convictional belief in the logic of it, and it surely is logical. And when you've got that, you're able to know the value of this lovely word of yours. And indeed, you can go thy way, and thy faith shall make thee whole.
Well, friends, Moon Trail has dealt with one aspect of faith in a very absorbing manner. Of course, he and I are old friends, and he knows what he's prepared to expect from so crude a person as myself. So far as faith is concerned, I'm going to put a question to Moon Trail, which may perhaps interest you, because probably the same question will have occurred to you. I personally have had a lot of opinions about faith, and I've written quite a number of articles on the subject, in which I've pointed out, or rather I've claimed, that faith is an actual force, just like the force of gravity. Now, I want to go a bit further than that and see what Moon Trail's opinion is on this point. Supposing I, or you, or anyone of us is confronted with a situation, a very difficult situation, full of problems and frustrations. Of course, it's quite obvious that if I have faith in my own ability to cope with it, that is a great asset. There's no question about that. But what I want to know is this. If I have that faith that he is speaking about, does it also act as a sort of cosmic force which will not only strengthen me in my efforts, strengthen my biceps and my mind and so on, but will also introduce into the cosmic influence something which will make the situation, make the solution a bit easier or a bit better or a bit more successful? I don't know whether I've explained that properly, but I'm sure Moon Trail will know what I'm getting at, and he can probably put it in much better words than I can. I want to know to what extent this faith that we are hearing about is an actual force, like the force of gravity, or if you like, the force of electricity, that we can utilize not only to strengthen our own point of view, but for other purposes as well.